Welcome to another episode of Hand Tool Resurrection with your host, Hand Tool Rescue.
Oh, hey. Didn't see you there. Just doing some late night reading. Found something that you might find interesting. It's a wrench patent from 1883. A very unique design, I would say. And I had an idea. Why don't we try and recreate this exact model as close as we can? I believe it's possible with the limited amount of tools available to me, and I think it would be interesting as I have never seen one in person, nor have I found any instance of this exact design online other than in this patent. So, if that interests you, please join me on an adventure on recreating and resurrecting this wrench. Okay, let's talk about how this turned out and what was great, what wasn't that great, and how it really performs as a wrench. Now, this is 1883. February 27th was the patent by Mr. Fred H. Seymour. I hope he would be interested in seeing this specific version come back to life as close as I could get it, personally. I assume he would be happy with it, because I am fairly happy with how it turned out. The main difference is, I tried to get as close as possible to the patent, obviously, but I ended up only doing one full twist here instead of two. That is just to do with the size of the wrench that I chose. In the patent, it doesn't give any dimensions, so I just had to kind of come up with a reasonable sized wrench, and this seemed to be appropriate. This fits nicely in the hand here. There are versions of a twisted style like this that do exist that have no slot milled in here and just have a kind of a nail coming out and bending around and locking in an adjuster. That's something that pretty much anyone could make at this point. This is just a little bit more complicated, I guess. Another thing that I learned was that when twisting, obviously having something here so these don't get closer together, the two sides near the twist, compared to over here, this kind of needs to be a consistent size so that this stays a consistent distance apart as well in order to get a nice sliding mechanism on here. I'm very happy with how the jaws lined up. I was worried that any little twisting or movement during heating would alter that, but it turned out fine. The adjuster is great, nice action, nice and smooth, and it works just fine. The case hardening turned out well. It is a very thin layer. I'm not sure how deep the case hardening was on these original wrenches since I have never seen one. Most monkey wrenches from this era were case hardened, but any type of case hardening isn't really going to get deep enough to stop any wrench mouth or any part of the wrench really from being dented. As you can see from a lot of older monkey wrenches, especially around here where they used it as a hammer, or even in the jaws, they're just soft and they were made of wrought iron. And what can you do? That's just the way it is. I particularly like that because then the fasteners stay nice and intact and not damaged. And then the wrench itself is for wrench purposes. If I had to do this again, I would put a piece of round stock here and a piece of round stock here when twisting to make that consistent distance. I'd also probably try and get all of these parts to be a higher carbon steel, one that I could actually heat treat and it would be as strong as possible, because I'm not really sure what this wrench can take. I would have loved to make another one where I could just ruin it for testing purposes, but just based on the construction, it can't be the strongest wrench that has ever been made. I did have a lot of fun doing this. Hopefully someone else out there would want to create something like this. I'll have tons of links in the description about different styles, even simpler ones without a twist, one with just a bend. There were a lot of variations on this specific design throughout the years, since it has been, you know, like 130 years since then. You can check those out if you want to. But I hope you enjoyed this type of video. I plan on doing more. I believe next up I'm going to do a hand plane that is also a chisel at the same time. It's another old patent that is ridiculous and I love it, and I hope to get to that one next. If you have any other patent finding abilities and want to send me some ideas, I would love to see some crazy patents out there that could potentially be recreated with the tools that I have. Nothing with 10 million parts like the apple peeler. Thank you very much. Something simple, at the very least, to start off with. Anyways, I hope you enjoy this, and I thank you all for watching.